A man stopped by Illinois construction workers for allegedly driving under the influence. News 11's Kelly Hoskins joins us live from Illinois State Police Headquarters with how construction workers caught him. Kelly?
Well, Mike, Illinois State Police say that the driver is now facing felony charges for allegedly driving while under the influence, also driving careless in a construction work zone. They say that these IDOT workers used quick thinking by boxing their driver in until police arrived. Bomarito Automotive Sky Fox was over the scene Wednesday morning near southbound 255 and Route 3. Investigators say the driver of a pickup truck ran into a construction barrel set up by IDOT road workers near the Dupo work zone.
The driver of the pickup pulled over. The construction workers approached him to see if they were in need of medical assistance or anything. And the driver of the pickup was actually utilizing drugs at the time on the shoulder.
Police say a quick-thinking IDOT worker boxed the intoxicated driver in with a bobcat. A construction worker called 911.
They did do the right thing, and actually once the driver stopped after striking several construction barrels and utilizing the drugs, when the driver observed the construction workers, he attempted to flee.
I'm very proud of my co-worker. He did a great job, but we all let state police, you know, finish their investigation. But quick thinking on both the contractor, the employee, and an excellent response from the police.
IDOT officials say every driver has a responsibility to exercise caution and good judgment in construction zones.
Just essential that the folks on the pavement that are driving be respectful and look out. We want the men and women that work on our roadways and bridges to go home safely. Slow down, be considerate, and definitely obey all the signs.
Imagine that's your father, your mother, your brother, your sister. If you know that they're in that particular zone, you will slow down. In this case, we're very thankful no one was seriously injured or killed.
Now, authorities say that drug paraphernalia was found in that man's vehicle. The case has now been turned over to the Illinois State's Attorney's Office, where charges are expected to be filed later today. Live in Collinsville, Kelly Hoskins, News 11.